All right, so I'm going to attempt a video to show how I do alcohol ink on a drum shell. This shell right here is a 12 by 14. It's a wood shell, so I primed it in white. And what we're going to do is we're going to use alcohol ink, and we're going to use cobalt, mostly because I'm trying to match two other ones that I've already done. And we're going to do some highlights in boysenberry and in vineyard also. Now, the things that you need is you need some gloves because this stuff will stain. You also probably want to put something down on the floor because, you know, as the ink moves and falls off the shell, it might go on the floor and make a big mess. You also want something that you can move the ink with. I use a little air puffer thingy, or sometimes even a hair dryer, and maybe sometimes a little bit of some canned air. Also, what you definitely need is isopropyl alcohol, and I would recommend either 91 or 99. It's kind of hard to find right now because of COVID, yeah, 70 won't really do what you want. Anyways, so my first step is I'm going to take some of that isopropyl alcohol, which I have in this little bottle here, and I'm going to put a little wash of it on the shell, sort of like this. Now remember that there is a scientific thing as gravity, so you're fighting that constantly. And I'm just going to drop some ink onto the shell. And as you can see, as I drop it, it really starts to move. Since it's a big area, I want to blow it out and away somehow. And you got to work fast because the ink will start to dry relatively quick, and then just keep adding ink where you want it. I wouldn't put it everywhere because you want to leave spaces. So as you can see, this dark stuff here has already started on drying. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little bit of the isopropyl alcohol onto it to basically reactivate it, and use an air puffer just to move it around a little bit, you know, and blend it out. And yes, I will have all the drips and stuff on the shell, but in time, you know, I will mix those in and blend them in. Now, when you're doing a real big surface, you probably go through a lot of this alcohol. And with the prices nowadays, let me tell you, it's not very cheap. But see, so I'm already starting, you know, on a little bit of the blend and the shapes and the texture. I'm just going to put more on there, throw more ink on there. Now, this bottle is about 0.5 ounces. I've already done two separate toms with this. Third of the bottle left, maybe. All right, I'm going to rotate this a little bit. No, actually, I'm going to do that. I'm going to reactivate with some more alcohol and get a little bit of a blowout going here. Because my intent at the end is I really want to cover, you know, all of this shell. Well, most all of it with this cobalt ink, so it will match my other stuff. For some reason, I'm not sure why, sometimes the ink won't stick in certain spots, and I don't know if it's because of the primer or because something else is going on. But as you can see, you know, I'm blowing the ink around, you know, just to make some different patterns. And as you can see, all the drips have already started. But that's okay, because we'll work with those. And we'll add alcohol and lighten them up, thin them out, and make them move. This is the fun about alcohol ink, that there really is no right and wrong. There are no rules. And whatever you make is really a one of a kind, because you can never make exactly the same patterns and the same shapes and, you know, the same color blends and all that. So I'm just trying to basically fill a lot of area on this 12 by 14, which is really one of the largest sizes that I've done so far. So it's going to be a little bit of ink, and it's going to take a little bit of time. But this is basically, you know, what the idea is. Just take more ink, add it on there, just let it drip around. It doesn't matter. And then blow it out. You know, with an air puffer or an air can like this. Now, you don't want to do it real hard, because if you do, then you're probably going to end up blowing a lot of ink off of the shell. And, you know, why do you want to do that, right? But, you know, anywhere that you have isopropyl alcohol on there, you can basically, you know, move all that ink. So I'm going to do a little bit more. You know, all the splatters here, I don't want the splatters. So I definitely want to, you know, soften them out and blow them out just by adding more alcohol. Now, a lot of artists who work in this medium all the time might look at what I'm doing and go, oh, man, what the hell is he doing? But you know what? As I said, there are no rules. There is no right and wrong in this medium. You can really do however it works, you know, and however you like it. So, as you can see, you know, so we're getting there little by little. Still have a lot of shell left. Now, you know, I can add color at any time. I'm going to take some Tim Holtz. This is boysenberry. And I'm gonna add a little bit in this little white area. Just put a little bit of alcohol there. I'm just gonna use like a drop. And I'm gonna try to move it around. And now I'm adding, you know, a little bit of some color into here. As much as I want, as little as I want. Just gonna lighten it up a little bit, blow it around. So, you know. So I can add that as a contrast, or as a mix, I guess. So let's try this place where the ink would stick and see what happens. All right, right there. So, see? It's blending and it's making, you know, a different sort of a color also, because, you know, because of color, of course, you know, if you mix two different colors, then of course you're going to get a third color. And this is basically what the idea is. And you can just keep going and going on the whole shell and just move it around, you know, add more ink where you want it. And, you know, work with alcohol, you know, with the isopropyl, because that will really activate the ink and let it run and do all sorts of weird stuff. I'm using the dryer again to blow this out. You can see it moving, but it dries really quick. The reason why it dries really quick is because with that hair dryer, then all of this alcohol evaporates real fast. So, you know, so the ink can't really do anything at that point because it can't move. It's basically, you know, it's hardened. Well, not really hardened, but and you can just keep moving ink around, you know, clear out all the splatters, get rid of your runs to make, just keep moving ink. And do it until you're satisfied and that's something you like. So I'm going to keep doing this, but I'm not going to bore you with the same technique that you've already seen. But I will try to show what the finished shell looks like after it's all done. But, you know, alcohol ink's kind of cool because, you know, you can do like some real, you know, abstract sort of art on your drums and basically, you know, do a one-of-a-kind thing, and it's yours, and you made it, especially in the midst of COVID, where, you know, I've just been sitting around the house, you know, isolating, of course, like you're supposed to do, but getting bored, so I started looking around on the internet and found a guy that was doing this alcohol ink stuff, and I was like, hey, I'm going to try that. So I went to Michael's, bought a pack of some ink. You know, it's like three bottles in the pack is like, you know, it's like $11 or $12 maybe. So it's really, you know, not a lot of money out of your pocket. Oh, yeah. See the nice color tints there and like the metallic kind of. So it's getting there. But yeah, you know, go to Michael's or, you know, anything like that. They should have alcohol ink on the shelf. And there's so many colors. I mean, there's like millions of colors. And you can just go crazy. I have a box over here. I don't know. I probably have about 15 or so bottles in different colors. And, you know, I just do it because I'm bored. And I have nothing else going on during COVID. So why not mess up some drum shells? Now, this ink is kind of, you know, so it's kind of permanent. If you do make a mistake, though, you can use alcohol and you can basically wipe it off. But after it's all done, you know, so you should seal it with something. I've been using this Krylon Kamar varnish. You know, to seal it, but you have to wait probably a good 24, 48 hours after you're finished to make sure that ink is, you know, all set and dried. Because if it's not, and then if you spray stuff on it, then you're going to start moving the ink. And you don't want to do that. So, you know, just wait. And then use that as a sealer, and, you know, you can put anything else, you know, on the top of it that you want, you know. And yeah, so the whole key here is to have fun and just make some weirdo creations, you know, stuff that you never thought you could do. Well, you can do it. And oh, one more important thing is a little bit of ink, you know, as you can see, it goes a long way. So, you know, it isn't like it's a big dump of ink on there. You know, it's a drop here, a drop there, and then, you know, isopropyl alcohol. And as you can see, you can drop it on and it will start to make its own little patterns if you're looking right over here. You know, it's making little circles, and, you know, if you don't like those, then blow them. Blow them out, move them around, you know, make other little edges and other waves, I guess you'd call it, of the ink. And just, you know, if it's too dark, you can put more alcohol on there, lighten it out, so on and so forth. All right, I think you've probably seen enough and you know, you got the idea. So yeah, have at it. Have fun. It's something new to do in the middle of this lousy, crappy virus that we're all dealing with. And yeah. So, I hope you have fun. That's Alcohol Ink 101, as best as I can do it. Thanks and enjoy.